Hello everyone, in this video we will be working on enabling Serial Console for Raspberry Pi 0 board. Serial Console is very important for embedded Linux boards running with lightweight operating systems where desktop is not enabled. Serial Console allows us to monitor the Linux log while it is booting up. Serial Console parameters like port number, baud rate are passed as a command line arguments or a boot arguments to the kernel from the U-boot. So let us see how the connections are made and what are the modifications we need to make for the operating system to enable the Serial Console.
This is how the connections are made between Raspberry Pi 0W and USB to Serial Converter. So if you look at 40 pin connector of Raspberry Pi 0, so pin number 1 is 3.3 volts, pin number 2 is 5 volts. And pin number 4 is again 5 volts. 6 is a ground pin, which is going to the ground of USB to serial converter. Pin number 8 is CPU 14, which is a UART 0 TX pin. So which goes to the RX pin of your serial converter. And this is RX pin of UART 0 of Raspberry Pi 0. And this is going to the transmit pin, that is the TXT pin of UART converter. So this is a simple connection actually, and we'll be powering up this board using a USB, and this will also get power from the host computer. So we don't need any additional connections other than the ground and the TXT RXT pins. So let us see what are the modifications we have to do in the configuration files and boot files. Now let us look at OS image loading onto the SD card. I am using Raspberry Pi Imager application to flash OS onto the SD card. The OS image I am using for this purpose is Raspberry Pi OS Lite image. But this procedure should be the same for all other kinds of Raspberry Pi OS images and other Raspberry Pi board variants. When the imager flashes OS image onto the SD card, what exactly it does is, it creates two partitions. One is boot partition, which is of FAT file system type. Another one is a root file system partition, which is a EXT4 partition. If you are using Linux host for flashing, you can see both the partitions, boot and root FS. Whereas on Windows PC, you can only mount boot partition. When the SD card is connected to the Windows host, we can see the boot partition. So let us go to the boot partition. In the boot partition, so we see like the kernel image and different DTB files which specify the device configuration. So as the OS image is common for all variants of the Raspberry Pi boards, so we see the different DTB files for different boards. Now we can go to the config.txt file, which is of interest for us to enable the Serial Console. Let us open this in a text editor. So go to the bottom of this file and add enable enable underscore UART is equal to 1. This is the configuration required for enabling the UART, and save this file and close it. Now let us go to the cmdline.txt file. This file consists of the boot arguments which will be passed to the Linux kernel from the bootloader. So this is the parameter which we have to pass for enabling the Serial Console. So here we are specifying the console should be Serial Console, and the port should be TTY1 port, and its baud rate. So this is enough for enabling the Serial Console for Raspberry Pi device. So now we can close this file unmount the device and keep it in the board for booting. After placing the SD card on the Raspberry Pi board, now let us connect the USB to serial converter to the host PC. You can see the COM port associated with this USB to serial converter by going to the device manager. So let us go to the device manager. And check for the ports, COM port. Here USB to serial port, COM5 is the port related to the USB to serial converter we are using. We can use this port to configure the serial turners like a taraterm or putty. I am using taraterm for this purpose. So open the taraterm and select the COM port 5 and go to setups and do the baud rate. So I am using the baud rate which we have given in that configurations. Now let us restart the board. When we power up the board, we can see the Linux kernel boot log on this serial terminal which we have enabled just now. So this is the advantage of enabling serial port. We can see the complete boot log of the Linux kernel even though you don't have a display connected. It is taking a while for booting completely. Yeah, once that boot is completed, it will go to the terminal. So we can use the default credentials like Pi and so this is how we can enable the serial console and use this.